Do you have money problems because of someone else's drinking?
Are you afraid or embarrassed to bring your friends home?
Do you feel that if the drinker loved you, she or he would stop drinking?
If you answered yes to any of these questions, you are not alone.
More than half of all adults have a family history of alcoholism.
Not everyone trapped by alcohol is an alcoholic.
Families and friends are suffering too.
Al-Anon and Alateen can help.
Call 1-866-200-0223 or visit alanon.org/help.
Join the movement. Listen to The Tori Lowe Show on 101.7 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
This is your 101.7 The Truth News Update.
Hello, everyone. This is Rhea Riley with your news update. 29-year-old Antonio Curran is being charged with first-degree reckless homicide and possession of a firearm by a felon in connection to a fatal shooting from Sunday, October 8th. Police were dispatched that Sunday morning and investigated a shooting that occurred near 89th and Dogwood. The victim was pronounced dead on the scene. According to detectives and witnesses, Curran performed the shooting before driving south in a tan Chevy Impala before clocking in for work. Curran appeared in court Sunday, October 16th, and a cash bond was set for $150,000. A dog is now missing after four individuals carjacked a vehicle Sunday evening. The carjacking took place around 6:30 p.m. near Oakland and North Avenue. The car has since been recovered, but the dog, George, is still missing. The suspects are said to be four black men between the ages of 18 and 19 years old. Most were seen wearing black pants and hoodies, and one was armed with a black handgun. Anyone with information about the incident is encouraged to contact the Milwaukee Police at 414-935-7360 or contact Crime Stoppers anonymously at 414-224-TIPS. That's 414-224-8477. According to a new report, Wisconsin has broken the record again for the most domestic violence deaths in 2022. The annual statewide homicide report, End Domestic Abuse Wisconsin, reported that in 2022 there were 96 lives lost, a 20% increase from 2021. This is alarming as the state is suffering from a 70% drop in federal funding to provide services to victims of domestic abuse. According to the State Department of Justice Offices of Crime Victim Services, the state will receive $13.5 million in grant funding for the next 3 years, a significant drop from previous funding cycle, which lasted 5 years and received $44.5 million in aid. On October 25th, several Wisconsin organizations who work with domestic violence will gather to speak with lawmakers to help create a plan for more federal funding. This has been your news update. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Bringing you his authentic perspectives on important topics.
They live in suburbs together. They live in the city together. They hang out together, all in the same family. We're the only idiots that fight because we want our voice to only be on one side. Like, does that even make any sense? And when the side loses, you lose everything. They, on the other hand, have a voice no matter what, because somebody that looks like them is always in control.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point.
Well, it's just a skewed system.
Of course it is.
It's a lot of a judgment.
But answer my question, though. Should we let people go? Should we let people go? Like, let's just forget about bail altogether. And if your neighbor commits a homicide and kills people up. If you kill people and they next to you and you just let them come back and live right next to you, they can live upstairs from you. Let them come in your house.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point. This is the best radio show in the state of Wisconsin. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth app.
Now, he's the mayor of the city of Milwaukee. He's a young man. Give him a chance. I only complain about things that I care about. What I want you to do is pretend like I'm in St. Louis. And all I'm asking the mayor and the Common Council president and the Common Council, show me.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Dr. Ken Harris.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. Having headphone issues. I'm always having headphone issues. Well, not always. But, you know, some things you're, what's the word I'm looking for? You have certain idiosyncrasies that have to be taken care of first before you do something else, right? What are some of those bizarre things that people do? Everything you do with your left hand, you have to do with your right hand. If you scratch your left hand, you have to scratch your right hand. What are those called? Like if you wiggle your nose to the left, you got to wiggle it to the right. What do you want to call them? Idiosyncrasies like splitting poles. Do you split poles, by the way? Yeah, like superstition. Yeah. So I've never ever been a person that was superstitious to where I didn't do something or did something because people get weird. You look like you want to say something.
I mean, you should never step on a crack.
Who cares? You break your mama's back? That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. Like when I heard it as a kid, I went, what? Step on a crack, break your mama's back. That just doesn't make any sense to me. But we hold on to so many bizarre, weird, strange things. I like things to be balanced. I'm one of those weirdos. I like things to be balanced. But everything can't be perfect, but it can be balanced, right? I'm one of those weird people, I have to have two of everything. Watch this. Okay, this will sound weird. What's my favorite candy that I eat? Altoids, right? I've been eating Altoids since I was in college. I discovered them at the University of Illinois, Chicago, in a store where I looked at them, and the mints at the time were a dollar. And I thought, oh my God, mints are 10 bucks, like 10 cents. A roll of mints, peppermint lifesavers was 10 cents. Might've been a quarter, you know, back in the 70s. They wanted 99 cents. I was like, oh, my God, that's expensive as I'll get out. I just saw Walgreens. They had them for $4.79. I'm like, okay, something wrong with y'all. I won't be getting them from there. But I do support Walgreens. They're one of my favorite places. But the point I'm trying to make is that prices have gone up. But when I eat them two at a time. Or if I eat four at a time. I don't know why I do that. If I eat sweet tarts, candy, if I have food, meat, I need two. Not the rice, not the peas or the green beans or whatever, but meat-wise, I need two small pieces. If it's not two, I'll cut it into two pieces and have two equal pieces. I don't know what that is. I don't know why I do that. 833-212-1017. Maybe I'm just broken. And I had to come to the realization that there are just some things in your life that no matter what you do, no matter what you say, you have broken places in your life. You have those spaces that aren't really built up like they should be. I can safely say, physically, I'm probably at about 95, 98%. Mentally, probably about 95, 98%. But there's some places I'm like 0.2. Like there's some things emotionally, physically, mentally, I'm just like,
It's that weak place. And I think everybody has it. Everybody has that space where they're weak, where they're broken, right? And it's not going to get fixed. You know, there are just some things in life you can't fix. There are some things in life that happen, and it sounds good that you want to try to fix it, but you can't. By the time my father died when I was 11, I had seen so many people on my father's side of the family pass away that it really didn't. I mean, I was sad, but I wasn't like shocked, but it still leaves you broken. And I had to realize that in that instance, there is absolutely positively nothing you can do to change it. I don't care how much you would cry. I don't care how much you would get happy. I don't care how much you would get upset. I don't care if you got, you know, whatever. You're never going to get over certain things, and you're never going to change it. And so I used to think about, so then what do you do when you have that space in your life that you don't let anybody in because it's that space that's broken, and if it comes out, it'll blow up in your face. What do you do? And so when I get, is it contemplative or contemplative? I've heard it both ways. I sit outside even when it's cold. Like it was 40 degrees the other day. I was sitting outside chilling, had a light. It was like maybe 8 or 9 o'clock, and I'm reading a book. Now, how strange is that when you're sitting here reading a book on, you know, on a Saturday night, Sunday night outside? And I came across a quote because I love quote books. You know, those things that make me think, that make me what? Contemplative. I still don't know which one it is. I got to figure that out. 833-212-1017. Is it contemplative or contemplative? I don't know. Either way, I came across a great quote by Ernest Hemingway. And I'm sitting here thinking, what can I do to make myself better? Like every day I want to be a little better. Yeah, I mess stuff up. I screw stuff up. I say things I shouldn't. I do things I shouldn't. But in those broken places, those little small areas that nobody knows about but me and maybe one or two other people, how do you deal with that? And I came across a quote by Ernest Hemingway. You know, for those of you that haven't heard about Ernest Hemingway, you know, great author, had his own issues. And I'm so busy, and again, I've said this on the radio, I'm so busy trying to be good at the things I'm good at and avoiding the things that I'm terrible at, but I never dealt with where I'm broken. And it dawned on me because I kept saying to myself, I'll never be broke and I'll never be broken, but there are some things that are already broken that are irreparable. There are issues and situations where you can't repair them. And then Ernest Hemingway summed it up for me in a way that I had not thought about it before. It was so simple, I was in awe. Ernest Hemingway said, you have to be stronger at the broken places.
And that is Dr. Ken's Truth on the new 101.7 The Truth.
It's Big Week for First Stage. Truth Nation, the NAACP Image Award nominated novel, The Forgotten Girl by India Hill Brown, will be coming to the Milwaukee Youth Arts Center in Milwaukee. The play follows the journey of teens looking to learn about their town's history of segregation. This entertaining play runs from October 20th to November 12th. Big Week on 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by First Stage. Visit firststage.org today to get tickets to The Forgotten Girl.
Hi, John McGivern here. Did you know Network Health Medicare Advantage plans start at $0 a month? And you can get the extra benefits you need, like dental, vision, over-the-counter items, and more? I know because I'm a member myself. Call 833-7-NETWORK to learn more today. Network Health Medicare Advantage plans include PPO plans with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in Network Health Medicare Advantage plans depends on contract renewal.
It's Big Week for First Stage. Truth Nation, the NAACP Image Award-nominated novel, The Forgotten Girl by India Hill Brown, will be coming to the Milwaukee Youth Arts Center in Milwaukee. The play follows the journey of teens looking to learn about their town's history of segregation. This entertaining play runs from October 20th to November 12th. Big Week on 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by First Stage. Visit firststage.org today to get tickets to The Forgotten Girl.
I noticed that my central vision started to blur.
Figures that are usually straight started to distort to become wavy.
What are these little dark spots with blurring that I'm seeing?
There's a blind spot like a blob over my vision now.
Is my vision lost forever?
Why did I wait so long to see a retina specialist?
Retinal disease can steal your eyesight, but it doesn't have to. Patients who seek care from a retina specialist in a timely manner have the best chance of preventing vision loss due to age-related macular degeneration or diabetic retinopathy. AMD symptoms to look out for are distortion or warping of straight lines, as well as blurred or loss of central vision. Patients with diabetic retinopathy should seek treatment if they notice the appearance of spots or floaters or blurred and distorted vision. Don't delay seeing a retina specialist. It's worth the visit to save your vision so you don't miss out on life's precious moments, like seeing your grandchild grow up, enjoying a sunset with that special someone, or reading a good book. Visit seeforalifetime.org.
The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. 833-212-1017 is the number. Can you hear my lazy speech? Truth in a afternoon? Not in the afternoon. In a afternoon? In a. Is it I-N-A or I-N-N-A? In a. Truth in a afternoon. Ebonics. 833-212-1017 is the number. I was looking at this story from JS Online about the youth advisor who's going to prison after admitting in open court he had sex with a 16-year-old student at Bayview High School. So, with all the people in the world, all the women in the world, a 24-year-old, Daniel Ellis Jr., 24, of Milwaukee, pled guilty today to sexual assault of a student by school staff. And Jeffrey A. Wagner, Milwaukee County Circuit Court judge, ordered him to serve 2.5 years in prison and 3.5 years of extended supervision when he was released. He was employed at the Milwaukee Christian Center to work in the violence-free zone program at the high school. The Christian Center has a contract with the Milwaukee Public Schools to operate the mentorship program at 5 schools. Ellis was accused in a criminal complaint of texting and calling the student, then meeting up with the student after school to talk. Ellis allegedly told the student he wanted to leave his wife and be with the student. Huh? Now, if you were 34 and 26, okay. Strange. 833-212-1017. What is happening to the student was a minor, not legally able to consent. Prosecutors allege Ellis had sex with the student on several occasions in his car between February and April. So my question is, I don't even know if I can ask any questions. I don't know if I can ask any questions because I'm trying to figure out how exactly does all this happen. A 16-year-old? Do we keep tabs on our children the way we're supposed to? Do we? I don't know. Where you are, where you're going. Now, I'm not going to put this on the student. I'm putting this on him. That is unconscionable. I'm sorry. That's unconscionable. What are your thoughts? 833-212-1017. A trusted mentor. Works at an organization. Investigators say Ellis texts the girl. She'd sneak out of her house to meet him. And so the girl's mother went through her daughter's phone, saw the messages, and called the police. Good mom. Good mom. And so the age difference makes no difference. It's an 8-year age difference. Makes no difference because she's a juvenile. Period. Full stop. End of story. No matter what anybody says, no matter what anybody thinks, she's a juvenile. She's a child. And I don't care how that quote-unquote child looks. I don't care how that child acts. I don't care how that child talks. I don't care how that child anything. It's beyond no means no. It's beyond no means no. I don't understand it. I don't get it. I'm reading another story and I'm trying to determine what date it was written, and I can't. It's from 58 days ago. A former teacher at a private school in Wauwatosa has been criminally charged, accused of having sexual relationship with a thin 13-year-old student, and then purchased him a firearm. Taisha Bolden, 34, eighth grade teacher at Pilgrim Lutheran, charged with second-degree sexual assault of a child, 16 and under, one count of providing a dangerous weapon to a person under 18, both felonies. Became the boy's teacher in October 2022. Soon thereafter began texting the student. By early 2023, she was sending nude photos and telling the student she loved him unconditionally. The mother informed the police in Brown Deer, where Bolden resides, on July 25th, that she believed her son and Bolden were having an inappropriate relationship. And the complaint says the mother found explicit photos exchanged between the two after going through her son's phone while he slept. According to the complaint, a supervisor of the school confronted Bolden on July 27th about a possible sexual relationship, and she admitted the student spent the night at her house. She also allowed the supervisor to go through her phone, where the supervisor found a number of explicit texts. The complaint says supervisor was then terminated her employment at the school. Student told investigators just before June, right before school was out for the summer, he and Bolden had sex after she picked him up and drove to a wooded area. What in God's name are you doing? The student said the inappropriate relationship came to an end July 21st at Mayfair Mall when he asked Bolden to buy him another gun. Bolden declined, get this, and then gave him $1,000. After the meeting, Bolden and the student did not speak to each other, according to prosecutors. Bolden could be sentenced up to what? How long you think she should go to jail for this, or could go to jail for this? Just off the top of your head. Just pick a number. Just pick a number.
I don't think I have one, because I feel like our justice system has done so many backwards things. So I don't know. And it's a woman, too.
So, what does that mean?
Well, we don't convict women so many times for this kind of thing.
Yeah,
so,
they do.
I mean, they do, but, like, compared to a man, that's a teacher.
That's because most many times men aren't believed. And many times men don't turn it in because they don't believe they're going to be believed. Like, I've literally witnessed and had to argue with a prosecutor of a man just being a victim of sexual assault. And it was a woman. And you know what she asked me? Well, what did he do? Are you kidding me? You're the prosecutor. We have this woman where she admitted battering her husband, and you're asking me what did he do? If I had asked her that about a woman, she would have written me up.
Yeah, that's what I mean. So I'm saying, like, most men will be convicted. I'm like, okay, the teacher was creepy, blah, 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 blah. But with this woman, I feel like, okay, if I throw in a number, I'll say 12.
In today's society, where everyone is sensitive, 12 years, 43 and a half. No, don't go, huh, no. Don't look. No,
oh,
no.
Good, I'm saying good.
Oh, okay. She had that look in her face like, what?
Yeah, no, it was looking good. She should have got longer. It's disgusting.
She was like, what? I was like, because that's what people think, right? They think, oh my God, a woman's going to get that much. Yeah, she deserves that much. This is a woman that's 34 years old with a 13-year-old. A 16-year-old, you might go, you know, I didn't make her run out. At least the guy was 8 years older, right? He's 24. So he's not that far removed from high school. Went through college already. Like, that's kind of like, no. But she's underage, can't do it. If she was 18 and he was 24, I'd be like, that's not cool. But they're both adults, right? Might want to watch the relationship, make sure he doesn't take advantage of her. When we're talking 34 and 13, no, you're done. Dig a hole. Dig a hole. I make you dig your own hole, jump in, and then put a dirt in on you. Now, that's pretty judgmental. They're going to take into account all the things that were in it, in the relationship. And then hopefully, because both of them, I believe, are sick, they're pedophiles. Now, being a pedophile is not against the law. Show me one law that says being a pedophile is against the law. Having the action from being a pedophile is against the law. In other words, having sex with a child is against the law. Sexual contact with a child is against the law. Liking children is not against the law. It's not. Any more so than lusting after a woman or a man is not against the law. Acting on it, sexual assault, is against the law. And so many times we take labels and we say, that person should go to jail. They're a pedophile. Right. That's why it's against the law to possess that type of material. But if you think it in your mind, you didn't act on it, right? But once you purchase something, once you possess something, jail, throw it away. And so many times in our minds, we have issues against labels, right? When in fact, we should be okay being labeled or labeling someone. We got, all of a sudden, we've changed and now we can't use labels. Now it's an issue trying to stop people from doing things because we don't use labels. My generation labels helped us understand, helped us get through things, helped us do all sorts of things because we were able to instantly garner attributes to that particular thing because we knew that that's what it was. Now, everything's just up for grabs. People slipping through the cracks. And then what? You have a 34-year-old woman and a 13-year-old boy. I don't get it. What are your thoughts? 833-212-1017 is the number. What should happen to teachers? Is there better screening that's needed for teachers? Is there basically, I don't know, you need to screen them the way you screen cops? Like, what needs to be done to ensure this doesn't happen to our children? Traffic, sports, and weather up next.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance, because you'll feel protected no matter how the wind blows. Also, you can keep enjoying the home of your dreams. And our expert agents can help you save up to 23% when you bundle home with auto. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. American Family Insurance. Get a quote? Find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Bucks basketball is back. A new era tips off with Coach Griffin at the helm, alongside returning favorites and exciting new additions. It's Dame time, Milwaukee. Don't miss a moment of the action. From the electrifying slam dunks to the roar of 18,000 fans, all unfolding live at Fiserv Forum. Secure your seats now. Visit Bucks.com/tickets and join us for an unforgettable season of Bucks basketball. There's a seat waiting for you at Fiserv Forum. Secure yours now at Bucks.com/tickets.
We didn't know what to expect. We were just left in a hotel.
My mom was doing drugs in the house.
Tay and Brianna spent years of their childhood in homes that weren't safe. They were placed in foster care and longed for a permanent, loving home.
I didn't know what my future was.
I wouldn't speak to anyone. I was afraid of everything.
With help from the Dave Thomas Foundation for Adoption, Brianna and Tay were adopted and now feel excited about their futures.
I'm studying to be a chef, and I really want to travel the world.
I'm going to be a mechanic, and I can focus on my career.
Right now, in the United States, there are more than 100,000 children in foster care, just like Brianna and Tay, who need a family now. Learn how you can help at DaveThomasFoundation.org.
Victor deployed for the first time to Afghanistan in 2003. At 4 in the morning, my phone rang. They said, "I regret to inform you that your husband was wounded in action." Victor sustained a moderate traumatic brain injury. I was doing school full-time, and I was also then caring for Victor. One of the most important elements of caregiving is taking care of yourself. I just didn't want to forget that I also had goals and that I also had a life. What I did is I challenged Victor to meet me halfway. There are almost 6 million military and veteran caregivers across the nation. We have our own journey, and we can fulfill that journey at the same time that we are helping our loved one.
Visit aarp.org/caregiving for a free military veteran's guide to navigate your caregiving journey and better care for your loved one and yourself. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
This is 1017 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community, and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations, where you can speak your truth. We are the new 1017 The Truth. Milwaukee, Black. Talk.
Northbound 43, we do still have this accident at Locust, blocking the right lane. 29 minutes to get from downtown to Brown Deer Road. That's going to be solid out of the Marquette all the way past that point. Southbound is also slow from just south of Silver Spring all the way down past Locust. That's a 22-minute ride from Brown Deer Road to downtown. Southbound 41 on and off the brakes, basically from Silver Spring all the way down past Mayfair Road. And the northbound side slowing down out of the Zoo Interchange up past Swan Boulevard. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight, partly cloudy with a low of 45 at the lake, 40 inland. Tomorrow, mostly sunny with a high of 61. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 1017 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 1017 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Brandon Snyde. Free time for the Milwaukee Bucks debuted last night under the bright lights in L.A. Damian Lillard and Giannis making their preseason debuts for the Bucks, and it did not take long for Dame time to tick in this one.
Damian Lillard's got it on the left wing. Lillard going to fire away. Three-pointer, yeah, baby. Dame knocks it down right after Giannis does on the opposite wing. Lillard sticks his first field goal as a Buck here in this preseason.
Giannis led the team in scoring with 16, while Lillard added 14 as the Bucks go on for the 108-97 preseason win over the Lakers. And lastly, the Texas Rangers taking the 1-0 series lead in the ALCS with a 2-0 win over the Houston Astros on Sunday night. This sports update is brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown teams. Member FDIC.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Whistle. Oops, I'm not supposed to know nothing about that music. Oops, my bad.
Let me sit here and be the nice old guy that I don't know what I'm talking about.
833-212-1017 is the number. Kiana, you're on the new 1017 The Truth. How are you?
Yo, listen. Hey, that's my grand too. But, hi. I wanted to say that I heard your question. I think, personally, that a lot of pedophiles have a hard time resisting the urges, right? So they start to form patterns of being someone who does things like that. I know when it comes to teachers, if an allegation is not found to be, you know, like they do an investigation and can't prove that this person has done it, it doesn't go on their record. I think that it should. I understand that people are falsely
Come on. Are you serious?
I do.
Every black person that walks through a store, if they think they're a thief or if they get stopped by the police, they should go in the system.
No.
That's what you just said.
This situation specifically when it comes to being a pedophile or a teacher, for instance.
So if someone accuses you of something,
I understand that people are falsely accused, but at the same time, for instance, I worked for a company and we got a new supervisor and we found out that he was having sex with one of our clients. Granted, she was 18 at the time, but she was still awarded to the state. And I know that he
had to have. That's different. No, you're talking about if you said if somebody gets accused of it. I don't want to know the story.
I don't want to hear the story.
I want you to answer my question that if you
because
get a kid. I'll never understand. If you get accused.
I'm pretty sure that wasn't his first time.
That's not the point. That's not
the point.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
About 4 years ago, I looked this man up, and he is in jail right now for sexually assaulting a child under the age of 16.
Listen, that's an argument that's matching your argument. That's evidence that you're finding to match your argument. The problem is you can only apply it to that argument. You can't apply that to me. If somebody accuses me of something, you're going to assume I did it? That's what you just said.
I think it should be written as a person has been accused.
Absolutely.
How else would you find the pattern?
Kiana, you tried to date. What do you mean pattern? So the pattern comes after you've been, after there's evidence. You're saying because there's no evidence, where there's not even smoke, but words, there's fire. You're jumping all the way to the end and acting as if this person did it.
You think all pedophiles or rapists get charged with a crime? Sometimes they don't find enough evidence to charge a person.
You're missing my point. You live in America. So what you're telling me is that I should be able to say that Kiana called me, sent me texts, pictures that I'm not supposed to have and all that, and now I want her arrested. And they should just go with it.
You wouldn't be able to prove that.
No, that's not what you said. That's not what you said. You said that if the accusation is made and they can't find evidence, we still leave it on their record.
I mean, in some form or fashion, yeah.
That's illegal. You're violating a person's civil rights. You know?
I know.
Okay, yeah. Well, where are you moving to? You moving to the Sudan or you moving to, Dubai?
Until these people get caught.
So you make the assumption that everybody's bad? Remind me. Hey, Kiana.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be my friend.
I am your friend.
No, you're not. No, you're not. That's because you listen to me. I don't know you. I don't want to talk to you. If you see me on the street, don't talk to me because I'm going to accuse you of something that you can't get out of. Luckily, we live in a country where you're actually innocent until actually proven guilty, not because someone thinks you're guilty.
I guess.
Because you're walking down a road. You're walking down a road of the thought police. Because now, every time you do something and we don't like it, we don't even have to bother. We can just lock you up.
Well, what would be your suggestion?
In terms of what?
The question, what can you do to either catch these people or what would be the solution to stop this from happening?
First of all, there are a number of things that have to happen, but everybody deserves to be investigated and looked at in an unbiased, unfair way. Even if you're found not to be guilty or not, there is no evidence. And understand, having no evidence is just that. You're only guilty when you're proven guilty in a court of your peers, not in the court of public opinion, not because of what somebody thinks and points at you and says, we don't like you. That's just opinion. But when you go through something like that, well, you have to get it because the same thing can happen to you. Someone that doesn't like you, someone that doesn't think you should be on the radio talking, calls and says, this is what Kiana did. And the fact that you were accused of it should be held against you on your record. And that in and of itself is a false pattern that they've now created. And now you're stuck with something.
One time or two times is not a pattern, but if someone called on
not true. Not true.
I probably would have to look in the mirror and see what I'm doing wrong.
Not true. Not true. I've seen whole groups of people not like a person and go out of their way to make sure that person was talked about, lied on, all sorts of things to get them thrown out of a company, to get them thrown out of an organization. I've watched it happen before.
Yeah, okay.
Either we follow the Constitution, the laws, or we don't. Either they apply to everybody or they don't. But when we start cherry picking, then I'm going to start picking Kiana. I think you broke in my car last night, by the way.
No. But if we had something like that, this guy that worked as my supervisor wouldn't have been able to hurt that little girl that he did.
Not true.
He wouldn't have been able to hurt.
Not true.
Or manipulate.
Not true. Because you're making an assumption about the future. Not true. You're making an assumption about the future that hasn't happened. You can't go on what you don't know and what you. Are you serious?
Yeah.
I don't think you'll be.
You know,
we have laws and civil rights and all that to work against that. That people actually discriminated against black people because they said, well, I mean, look at him. You think he can do the work? So then what are you talking about?
I mean, that was then, though.
What? This has happened last week. People have been looked at and told they couldn't get jobs and wouldn't get hired for all kinds of reasons. People still get around the Civil Rights Act. Come on.
Yeah.
So at some point, we have to give everybody the same rights we want, whether we want to or not.
Okay.
And it hurts and it's painful, but you would want the same thing done to your son or daughter if somebody said, hey, he touched me, and nobody heard the context, and all of a sudden they're accusing him of being a pedophile when, in fact, the little girl was hurt. She broke her leg, and he had to hold her leg in place. You know what I'm saying? And then somebody sees it, and they assume the wrong thing. Based on what you said, that would go on his file. And now people be like, well, I don't know if we should hire him because he got that, you know, thing on his file. He didn't do it, but we don't know.
Well, other than that, I don't know.
Okay.
Call rejected.
All right.
All right.
Have a good one. 833-212-1017 is the number. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris, for Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. You know, Team Pella is executing some incredible plays these days. Products with limited lifetime warranties. Incredible innovations like blinds and shades between the glass. Stylish windows, hidden screens that make the game day a breeze. Because, you know, every time I have a TV in my house that is sitting right in a space where when the sun and the lights come on, I can't see anything. So I moved the TV, and now when the sun comes on, there is a space on the side of my house, on my neighbor's house, where the light reflects and hits my TV. I'm like, I'm done. I'm not moving my TV anymore. What I really need is blinds and shades, and that's what you have. Installation is completed in as little as a day. See, I can get that fixed in a day. I can be done. No hassle, no muss, no fuss, no everything. You know, pick up all your stuff that you done put down. Perfect results. Schedule your free consultation today at PellaWI.com. That's PellaWI.com.
More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. Friday Night Lights now officially lives here. 1017 The Truth is the proud new home of Marquette University High School football. Be sure to tune in to Marquette Hilltoppers football every Friday night at 7 p.m. as we bring you some of the best gridiron action in the area. Marquette University High School football is presented by Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all. And sponsored by Capital Insurance Agency, Magic Productions, Annex Wealth Management, C.G. Schmidt, Left's Lucky Town, Liberty Engineering, and Marquette University High School.
Hardworking family businesses, ambitious entrepreneurs, relationship builders, job creators, businesses like yours are the heart of Wisconsin, and Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation lives to help you realize your vision. Join us for Marketplace Wisconsin, the Governor's Conference on Diverse Business Development, held December 6th and 7th at the Baird Convention Center, downtown Milwaukee, virtually on the 5th. Presented by WEDC. Marketplace Wisconsin is a chance for minority, women, LGBTQ+, veteran-owned, and small businesses to network, explore government contracting, and grow. You keep our state moving with construction, janitorial services, logistics, and transportation, technology, medical services, and much more. The Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation wants to help propel your success. Join us at Marketplace Wisconsin, the Governor's Conference on Diverse Business Development, December 6th and 7th. Register for Marketplace Wisconsin by going to MarketplaceWisconsin.com. Let's move forward together.
Hi, John McGivern here. Did you know Network Health has Medicare Advantage plans that give you $25 a month back towards your Medicare Part B premium? That's $300 a year back in your pocket. Isn't that great? Call 833-7-NETWORK to learn more today. Network Health Medicare Advantage plans include PPO plans with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in Network Health Medicare Advantage plans depends on contract renewal. Certain restrictions apply to the Part B giveback. Visit networkhealth.com/Medicare/extra benefits for details.
All right, Team Pella, listen up.
Thanks, John Kuhn. Customers love our products with limited lifetime warranties.
It's 101.7 The Truth. Dr. Ken Harris for Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Check out these big plays. Incredible innovations like blinds and shades between the glass. Stylish windows with hidden screens that make game days a breeze. With monthly payments as low as $19 per window, $75 per patio door, and a free quote at PellaWI.com.
Let's go.
6.99 APR for 120 months. Service restrictions apply. See showroom for details. Offers on 10/31/2023.
This is 101.7 The Truth, Dr. Ken Harris, and I am Milwaukee. Truth in the Afternoon is a platform where you and I can share our love, our lives, and our journey together. That is why, as a fan, your perspective is key. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 101.7 The Truth. Milwaukee, Black Talk.
The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. I want to remind you to tune in to the award-winning 101.7 The Truth this Saturday, 11 a.m. We got another episode of Greater Milwaukee Urban League's Entrepreneurship Connection show powered by Molson Coors. I'll be joined by Michael Demer, founder and author of The Lonely Entrepreneur, and we will discuss the importance of entrepreneurs having access to business resources, year-round networking, AI, all that stuff, as a way to build and develop your business. Again, that's the Greater Milwaukee Urban League's Entrepreneurship Connections, powered by Molson Coors, this Saturday, 11 a.m. on the award-winning 101, the 7, the truth. I just put the in front of them. The 1, the 0, the 7. 833-212-1017 is the number. So I'm looking at all this. I'm watching people be so torn over the Hamas-Israeli blow-up, I guess that's what you call it. Yeah. And I'm convinced, because somebody who's significantly younger than I said that they believe that, yeah, this is from the 1940s, you know, 1948 and 67 war, the Six-Day War, all that. This is from the 40s. And I'm like, if you want to go back to Isaac and Ishmael, like back in the Old Testament and the Torah, yeah, you might want to go back that far. Then you'll see the warring factions, right? Actually, it's two brothers. And really today, because Christianity, Islam, and Judaism hold Israel to be a birthplace of their religion, you start to see how all of them believe they're missing their blessing. And that if they could just occupy the land, it's their blessing to occupy the land. It's theirs. And I don't know if you can break it down to that basic an argument, because so many things have happened over time. So many things have happened to both the Israelis and the Palestinians. And I don't know if it'll ever. I don't know if it'll ever be over. Honestly, I don't think so. I think till Jesus come back, and it ain't gonna be over. It's not gonna be over. Oh, by the way, in the 5 o'clock hour, we'll be giving away a little loot. We'll be giving away access to loot. How's that? You'll be entered in to win. All you have to do is qualify, and calling in, you'll qualify for the One call, that's all, 5K giveaway. So that'll be in the 5 o'clock hour. Make sure you hang around and listen. And we'll be talking about that. We'll do the top five at 5. Talk about all sorts of things that are going on and happening in the world today. I think it's important. Everybody's so tense. Everybody's so on edge that we are so stressed that I don't know. And so if you have any comments on what's going on, and I wanna preface this by saying, if you're a hardliner Israel or hardliner Hamas, I don't know if that's germane to the conversation. I think understanding the issues that are going on in the Middle East and understanding what the solution would be, right? I'm more interested in solutions. I'm more interested in what can be done to fix it. And I don't mean fix it, let's eradicate, blah, blah. No. Because what we're dealing with is we're dealing with human beings. And as an American citizen, life and liberty are paramount. I mean, that's just for me. I believe they're paramount to all the things we do. So let's take a little time, breathe a little breath. And so I think it's important that we do that. So we're going to be breaking pretty soon for, you know, news. And I think I'll just take the call before I do my top five at 5. I'll be nice. I'll be understanding. All right. It's big week for First Stage, Truth Nation, and the NAACP Image Award nominated novel, The Forgotten Girl by India Hill Brown, is coming to Milwaukee Youth Arts Center right here in Milwaukee. The play follows the journey of teens looking to learn about their town's history of segregation. This entertaining play runs from October 20th through November 12th. Big week on 117 The Truth is sponsored by First Stage. First Stage, you can visit them at firststage.com. You can get tickets to The Forgotten Girl. Remember, that's this October 20th through November 12th, First Stage Theater. Big week on 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by First Stage. Visit firststage.com to get tickets to The Forgotten Girl.
It is big week for Network Health. Truth Nation, the annual Medicare enrollment period is here. Network Health offers great health plans for you to enroll in. Medicare is health insurance for people 65 and older and some younger people with disabilities. If you or a loved one meets these qualifications, you must tune in to our educational Big Week interview with Network Health this Wednesday on The Truth with Sherwin Hughes at 11 a.m. and Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris at 5 p.m. Learn more about the great health plans for Network Health during Big Week on 101.7 The Truth.
Tap into the best power hour in radio in Milwaukee.
Know yourself.
Yeah, he says know thyself. But yeah, tomato, tomato. It's giving potato, potato.
Yeah.
But I like that you said that.
Or Nelly Furtado.
Mm-hmm. Did you say Nelly Furtado? All right. I'm going to move past that.
Tomato, tomato.
Potato, potato. Nelly Furtado.
Yeah, my life.
Okay, they kind of like that. I'm done.
Go ahead, Mel.
I know, Ben. My stop. Bad. It's okay.
Listen to Nothing But the Truth with Melanie Ricks weekdays from noon to 1 on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
A promise is potent. Born of intention, fueled by commitment. It's seeing things through. Always showing up. And we know a thing or two about promises here at Susan G. Komen. Over 40 years ago, we locked arms with you toward one vision. A world without breast cancer. By investing in life-saving research and standing up for patient rights, we are shifting the system so all people, everywhere, get the care they deserve. Because if you've just been diagnosed and don't know where to turn, we've got you. If you can't afford the treatment you need, we've got you. And if you are driven to raise money to honor the best friend you've just lost, we have a place for you here. Because of you, we're supporting those who need help today while tirelessly searching for tomorrow's cures. Ending breast cancer needs all of us. Visit Komen.org and be a part of the Susan G. Komen community today.
All right, folks, let's get started. Parents, thanks for coming. As many of you know, I'm Coach Mather. Tonight I want to talk about the season, of which I only have one expectation, that everybody gets stronger. When I say get stronger, I'm not referring solely to physical strength. Sure, we'll be in the weight room, we'll be running stairs, but we're also going to focus on developing mental toughness and grit, because those are the characteristics that allow us to achieve greatness both on and off the court. So, how do we develop those things? By getting comfortable with a challenge. By cultivating the confidence necessary to overcome adversity in all forms. That's why I coach. That's my purpose. Every member of this team can lean on me, and I'll teach them how they can lean on themselves and each other.
This message presented by the WIAA and the Wisconsin Athletic Directors Association.
Listen to the man who tells you exactly how he sees it. The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris every weekday from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. on 101.7 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station. This is your 101.7 The Truth news update.
Hello, everyone. This is Rhea Riley with your news update. 29-year-old Antonio Curran is being charged with first-degree reckless homicide and possession of a firearm by a felon in connection to a fatal shooting from Sunday, October 8th. Police were dispatched that Sunday morning and investigated a shooting that occurred near 89th and Dogwood. The victim was pronounced dead on the scene. According to detectives and witnesses, Curran performed the shooting before driving south in a tan Chevy Impala before clocking in for work. Curran appeared in court Sunday, October 16th, and a cash bond was set for $150,000. A dog is now missing after four individuals carjacked a vehicle Sunday evening. The carjacking took place around 6:30 p.m. near Oakland and North Avenue. The car has since been recovered, but the dog, George, is still missing. The suspects are said to be four black men between the ages of 18 and 19 years old. Most were seen wearing black pants and hoodies, and one was armed with a black handgun. Anyone with information about the incident is encouraged to contact the Milwaukee Police at 414-935-7360 or contact Crime Stoppers anonymously at 414-224-TIPS. That's 414-224-8477. According to a new report, Wisconsin has broken the record again for the most domestic violence deaths in 2022. The annual statewide homicide report, End Domestic Abuse Wisconsin, reported that in 2022 there were 96 lives lost, a 20% increase from 2021. This is alarming as the state is suffering from a 70% drop in federal funding to provide services to victims of domestic abuse. According to the State Department of Justice Offices of Crime Victim Services, the state will receive $13.5 million in grant funding for the next 3 years, a significant drop from previous funding cycle, which lasted 5 years and received $44.5 million in aid. On October 25th, several Wisconsin organizations who work with the domestic violence will gather to speak with lawmakers to help create a plan for more federal funding. This has been your news update. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris continues on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Bringing you his authentic perspectives on important topics.
They live in suburbs together. They live in the city together. They hang out together, all in the same family. We're the only idiots that fight because we want our voice to only be on one side. Like, does that even make any sense? And when the side loses, you lose everything. They, on the other hand, have a voice no matter what, because somebody that looks like them is always in control.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point.
Well, it's just a skewed system.
Of course it is.
It's a lot of judgment.
But answer my question, though. Should we let people go? Should we let people go? Like, let's just forget about bail altogether. And if your neighbor commits a homicide and kills people up. If you kill people and they next to you and you just let them come back and live right next to you, they can live upstairs from you. Let them come in your house.
Frank, candid and straight to the point. This is the best radio show in the state of Wisconsin. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth app.
Now, he's the mayor of the city of Milwaukee. He's a young man. Give him a chance. I only complain about things that I care about. What I want you to do is pretend like I'm in St. Louis. And all I'm asking the mayor and the Common Council president and the Common Council,
Show me.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Dr. Ken Harris.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris, 833-212-1017 is the number. Charlotte, you're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth. How are you? Hello, Charlotte. Hello, Charlotte. Hello? Hello? How about no? 833-212. She didn't. Nothing. She didn't come back. She didn't say hello. She didn't say I'm here. Hopefully she'll call back. Hopefully she'll call back. I don't know what that was. Was she shuffling or like picking up? I can't hear it through the glass. She'll call back.
Number 5.
CBS 58, a man charged with criminal charges in connection with a 12-year-old's death. Jakari Robinson's body was found October 10th near 39th in Elmhurst, so badly malnourished and decomposed that at first the medical examiner's office was unable to positively identify him. Robinson's death was first ruled suspicious and then a homicide. Last Saturday, Milwaukee County District Attorney's Office issued charges against Ramuan, R-O-M-U-A-N, Moy, M-O-Y-E, for neglecting a child which resulted in death, and Moy remains on the run. He's charged with one count of chronic neglect of child consequence and death, one count of chronic neglect of a child consequences bodily harm, one count of neglect, chronic neglect of child, and one count of failure to report death of a child. If convicted, he could face up to 82 years in prison and fined $45,000. Why would we fine him $45,000? He should never get out of prison. So what are we doing? What are we doing? If you have any information, contact Milwaukee Police at 414-935-7360 or Crime Stoppers, where you can remain anonymous at 414-224-TIPS.
Number 4.
A Milwaukee man who was a trusted mentor at a Milwaukee public school pled guilty on today to a charge of sexual assault of a student by school staff. Daniel Ellis Jr. was then sentenced by Milwaukee County judge to 2.5 years in prison and another 3 years of extended supervision. Milwaukee police say Ellis sexually assaulted a teen girl multiple times from February to April. Prosecutors say the girl became pregnant. The girl's mother says Ellis met her daughter while she was a student at Bayview High School in Milwaukee, and prosecutors say Ellis was a youth advisor at the school for the group Violence Free Zone. So what do we do? Do kids need to be in like same-sex schools now? But that won't stop it. That won't cut down on it. So what do we do? Train up our children better? Thank goodness this mother was smart enough to figure it out and smart enough to come up with something that can help her child. And unfortunately, the child is pregnant, and sending this guy to jail. Oh, you missed that part? The 16-year-old's pregnant. So why are you shocked? That's what happens, you know, that happens. You do the horizontal mamba. And yeah. So let's just go here. Anytime you're ready.
Number 3.
Milwaukee police are asking for the public's help in finding a suspect wanted in connection with an armed robbery and carjacking. The incident happened on the 15th, which was yesterday, just before 6:30 p.m. Oakland and North Avenue on Milwaukee's east side. The four suspects took the victim's vehicle, which contained his dog, at gunpoint. The vehicle was recovered. George was not in the car. The dog. I was just like, my dog's in there, my dog's in there, said Richard Hoover, man who had his car and dog stolen. I immediately called 911. All I could think about was my dog. George is a 10-month-old Havanese that weighs about 15 pounds and has silky white fur with brown spotting and greenish to brown eyes. He's just a great puppy. He loves to fetch, chasing squirrels. I barely slept last night, and they're offering a $500 reward for George's safe return. Officials describe the suspects, African-American male, 18 to 19, 6 feet tall, 170 pounds. He has black, twisty-style, medium-length hair, and last seen wearing a black hooded sweatshirt with a colorful design on the chest. Suspect 2, African-American, 18 to 19 years of age, 5'10", 150 pounds. Has black, twisty-style, medium hair. Last seen wearing a black hooded sweatshirt with a colorful design on the chest, black pants, and was armed with a handgun. Suspects 3 and 4 described as African-American male, 18 to 19 years of age, all wearing black clothes. You notice the pattern here? So when you see groups that are dressed the same, that is when you should be on a, you know, you should always have your head on a swivel, right? But you should be aware that what's happening is they're making it difficult for you to identify an individual because they know under stress, people cannot make good identifications. The percentages in terms of accurate identifications is in the 20-25% range, around in there, under stress. So you're not gonna, you do remember that it was a black male, he had twisty style, medium hair, and that he was wearing all black. And there was some kind of design on the front. Because they were all dressed that way on purpose. Because when you do that under stress, facial details are rare unless you're a trained observer. If you've been trained to identify people automatically the same way, I notice people the same way every single time. I have a pattern when I look at a person to identify them. So later in my short-term memory, I can recall. Most people have that, but it's how you do it. That's just my technique, one of them. But when you see groups that are dressed alike and it's not a baseball team and it's not a team at all, you should go, Now, does that mean that you're being judgmental? Yes. Many people would not be in some situations they're in because they were not judgmental. You need to be judgmental. You need to look and go, and question if it is safe. I am judgmental about certain suburbs in Milwaukee. There are some suburbs I will not go to. Why? Because I've had significantly negative interaction with police and people in that particular suburb. I just don't go. Hey, we're going to, oh, that's nice. I'll see you all somewhere else. When I do go to that suburb, I literally go, but when I get off the expressway, I drive like a block or two. When I leave, I turn back around and get back on the expressway because I will not go to this suburb. They're terrible. I'm not going to say the suburb. I might need their help one day with the police. You never know. But it's a suburb in Milwaukee County that I just completely and totally stay away from.
Number two.
Wisconsin's Governor Evers has $170 million more dollars. Democratic Governor Tony Evers will use newly discovered federal dollars. They just came out of nowhere, girl, just dropped out of the sun. Oh, look. To keep a pandemic-era child care subsidy going for another year and a half, his administration announced today after Republican legislators refused to devote any more money to the program. Well, officials with Evers' administration said they will use $170 million from the Federal Emergency Management Agency pandemic response operations to keep child care counts program running through June 2025. Evers ripped Republicans in a news release saying that it's unconscionable that the GOP wouldn't extend the program. And so I'm trying to find out what exactly is the program. Launched in 2020, Child Care Counts program provides child care providers across the country with money to retain staff. Why are we paying child care money? Like, aren't we back to normal? We're actually paying money for child care providers to retain staff, cover curriculum, utility, and rent costs when we're back to... They already handed out $600 million to nearly 5,000 child care providers between March 2020 and March 2023, according to the state's nonprofit legislative fiscal bureau. The program is set to expire in January, leading many to warn that the loss of subsidies could lead to child care providers shutting their doors. Well, how could you? Who stays open and you're a business and you can't afford to stay open because you don't have anybody in your business? Like, I'm not understanding why the state would spend money to keep a business open that doesn't have the ability to generate money to stay open. So now we're giving. And how can you say it's okay to give welfare to these businesses, but you don't give welfare to other businesses? See, that is old school talking out of both sides of your face. $300 million in state money for the program over the next 2 years. So even has been trying to persuade Republicans to use Wisconsin's $7 billion surplus to keep child care counts afloat in Wisconsin. But why would we spend money on a business that can't keep itself afloat instead of finding alternatives for the students, for the kids? Is it that parents aren't bringing them back? Is it that parents don't want to be in that particular child care setting? Why would we pay? That doesn't make any sense to me. We subsidize very few other businesses in the state of Wisconsin. And when we subsidize them for, I think, weird reasons. But yet we have all this ARPA money and we have all these things. But of course, you got to go through the state. Now, is that guy, the speaker, being a little, you know, Robin Voss is being a little mean? Sure. But I don't think we need $300 million to keep child care centers open that don't have any children there. It's the balance of business. If you want to stay in business, you generate business and revenue. And if you can't, you actually close.
Number one.
On a lighter note, do I seem to have a problem with everything? Yes. Good. Leaf collection operations got underway today. According to the City Sanitation Services, residents should rake their leaves to the curb lanes to be collected and composted. However, leaf collection ends November 15th. After the deadline, residents can opt to mulch the leaves in their yard or drop them off at a drop-off center. Here's my question. Have your leaves fallen off your tree yet? No. Look outside. All the trees are full. So why are you starting now? I don't understand. Did I miss something? We're actually starting at a time when leaves are not falling off the trees. Okay. And then you run it for a month. And then the last month, right? It'll be like last year. I kid you not. The pile was so high on my corner, I had to call the city to tell them, I don't really care if you don't come pick it up now. You need to actually spread it out so that we can actually see in there and there's not a car crash at the corner. Because you have the leaves piled up and you didn't pick them up. So I don't get it. Maybe I'm just getting old and crotchety. Oh, wait. Maybe I am old and crotchety.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
It's Big Week for First Stage. Truth Nation, the NAACP Image Award nominated novel, The Forgotten Girl by India Hill Brown, will be coming to the Milwaukee Youth Arts Center in Milwaukee. The play follows the journey of teens looking to learn about their town's history of segregation. This entertaining play runs from October 20th to November 12th. Big Week on 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by First Stage. Visit firststage.org today to get tickets to The Forgotten Girl.
Life's better with an auto policy from American Family Insurance. No matter what dreams you're driving towards. That's because our expert agents will make you feel totally protected with the right auto coverage at the right price. You'll also save up to 23% when you bundle auto with home. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and we are proud to share an encouraging story from The Truth's general manager, Cherie Harris, of thriving through her breast cancer diagnosis.
So thrive through, what does that mean to you?
Thrive through means you are intentional about living your best life. And that is important for me because having cancer does not define me. It does not control everything about me. It's something that happened to me that I have to fight and I have to thrive through it. So for me, it's about each day waking up and living my best day. What is that going to look like? And it doesn't have to be super big. It could be, I just want to get out of bed and take a walk. Or I just want to go and get me some frozen yogurt. Whatever makes me happy, I'm going to thrive through and get there. Because cancer can really beat you down to the point where you don't want to do anything. So you have to figure out what that best thing is going to be about that day. And that's what thrive through means to me.
And how did you find those two words to be the mantra that you were going to live by?
I feel like I live by that mantra every day before cancer. And it was something I decided to define for myself when I was diagnosed with cancer, because it's a reminder of who I am, who I was, and who I want to continue to be, and how I'm going to reset my chapter. So thriving through means I'm going to get up every week and go to chemo. I'm going to get up every day and go to radiation. I'm going to thrive through that surgery and come out as a better person and hopefully just have the best life, you know, new life. And it's not something where I have to be embedded, like, did I thrive through? Is this what it means? It just means being your best self no matter what happens to you, because you can't control what you can't control, but you can control your happiness. And that's what I'm going to do.
101.7 The Truth and Good Karma Brands is proud to celebrate the fight against breast cancer.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. It's Big Week for Network Health, Truth Nation. The annual Medicare enrollment period is here. And Network Health offers great health plans for you to enroll in. You just heard it and you're hearing it again. That's how important it is. Medicare is health insurance for people 65 and older and some younger people with disabilities. So if you or a loved one meet these qualifications, you must tune in to our educational Big Week interview with Network Health this Wednesday with Sherwin Hughes at 11 a.m. and little old me, Dr. Ken Harris, although my name is spelled wrong, Harris, H-A-R-R-S, at 4:30 p.m. Learn about this great new health plan for Network Health during Big Week. That's right here on 101.7 The Truth. 833-212-1017 is the number. What's up, Al? You're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
What I was going to say, you know, when teachers are found, you know, I think at the time of their hire, maybe they can reiterate, you know, this is the consequences of if you get caught messing with a underage girl or whatsoever. My main concern is that the law will be right for everybody. Prime example, I believe this was in the Carolinas, a teacher was sleeping with a boy from the football team. Teacher was seen at many events, but the boy on the football team was charged with rape. But the teacher got a slap on the wrist because they just thought she was so the damsel. And there was another situation in Ohio where two boys raped little girls, and the judge said, well, he was worried about the kids going through life, and they got probation, and they didn't have to register on the sex offender list. But, of course, they are a different color from the color we are.
Right.
I just think, right, I just think if they're going to have a law to, you know, crucify, and everybody should, you know, pay for their actions, that law should be one way for everybody. It should not be if a teacher is of another nationality and it's known she's sleeping with another child, and because the child is black, he got to get charged for rape when she should be charged for rape. Or if a judge knows these two young white boys is raping girls, judge should not be worried about their life going, their life in going to college because they're white and they look like his son. If they rape somebody, they should register on a sex offender list, and they should have the same penalty in being in dealing with the law versus everybody else. Because now that opens up the door why a lot of people don't trust the law, because it's one set of rules for one people and another set of rules for other people. And we can't move forward if they say one can do this, but this one is going to be crucified, but this other one ain't going to get crucified because they look like one of my own. And that's my, but that's my only thing, and I just wanted to share that.
All right, thank you much. I mean, Al's right. Al is, he's accurate. I think many times, especially people are smart, right? They ask for a bench trial because the kids look like the judge. And many times black judges are trying to make sure that they're fair and equitable. And so they like hammer the kid. And I'm talking in some general ways, right? But many times in these suburbs and these rural areas, it's predominantly white, and the judge is more lenient than having a jury trial. Because I can't imagine a jury of your peers not hammering you for having sex with a child from that community. But of course, if you're smart, you have good grades, it was just a mistake. Well, if it's a mistake, it's a mistake for everybody at that age. That means no minor should be charged with sexual assault then. I don't know. 833-212-1017 is the number. What are your thoughts? I mean, do we allow the system to work? And I'm speaking the judicial system where you go to trial and get prosecuted and have a defense attorney and a jury or bench trial. Like, which would you prefer, a jury trial or a bench trial? Would you prefer the judge to make the decision, or would you prefer a jury of your peers to make the decision? 833-212-1017 is the number. Tune in to the award-winning 101.7 The Truth this Saturday, 10 a.m., for another episode of Diversity and Excellence powered by Erie Insurance, hosted by me and Fred Johnson, Vice President and Wisconsin State Manager for Erie Insurance. We'll discuss how the changing weather patterns are impacting how insurance companies are reviewing policies and claims. So don't miss Diversity and Excellence powered by Erie Insurance this Saturday, 10 a.m. right here on the award-winning, the ubiquitous, the stupendous, the magnanimous 101.7 The Truth.
More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
How much does it cost to talk to Gruber Losses after a serious crash? It's free. Yes, free. As in, it won't cost you anything to speak with us. Not sure if you have a case? Call our team at Gruber Law Offices today. Your first call and your first consultation are always free. And you'll never pay us a fee until we win your case. If you've been seriously injured, call Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
People across Wisconsin are enjoying the rewards, stability, and flexibility of a career in healthcare. Why not you? Wish Caregiver Careers can get you started as a certified direct care professional. You'll learn the skills you need to make life better for older adults or people with a disability. All training is free and online, plus earn $500 in bonuses. Start your new career. Sign up today at WISCCDCP.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Department of Health Services.
Times of transition, whether from a sad event or a joyful one, can leave us feeling adrift. Social connections are an important part of a healthy life. Being isolated and lonely can be harmful to your health. It can lead to high blood pressure, a greater risk of heart disease, and early onset dementia. So it's important to build and maintain connections to people, not just in your family, but others whose relationships bring meaning to your life. Trying a new hobby, volunteering, exercising, even using your phone or other device to stay in touch with others. All these can be great ways to keep up your social connections and your physical and mental well-being. Visit connecttoeffect.org to see if you're at risk of social isolation and find ways to get connected. Presented by AARP Foundation with support from United Healthcare.
The Age of Reason took place over 200 years ago. It was a time of amazing scientific and philosophical progress all over the world. Truth, reason, and tolerance thrived and even shaped the Constitution of the United States of America, the foundation of our democracy. But now those building blocks of America, of democracy, are under attack. In just two decades, big tech social media billionaires have allowed their platforms to roll back truth, facts, and tolerance, and fill the screens in our homes and in our pockets with lies and hate. Online disinformation and hate affect everything, everyone, everywhere. It splits us apart, hurts our children, polarizes our societies, and is literally leading to violence and terror in our communities. Lies and hate everywhere are a threat to all people, anywhere. Be a part of the change. Help defend the future of our democracy. Go to counterhate.com to learn more.
Well, we got a crash now on the ramp from Silver Spring to 41 southbound, so watch out for that. We've also got some delays along northbound 43 in Ozaukee County, heading up towards a disabled vehicle that's blocking the right lane north of Highway C. So keep that in mind. Of course, that's in the construction zone, so it's going to make for a big delay there. Westbound 94 backed up out of the Marquette all the way through to about Mitchell Boulevard. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight. Partly cloudy, a low of 45 at the lake, 40 inland. And tomorrow, mostly sunny with a high of 61. For the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 101.7 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Brandon Snyde. Free time for the Milwaukee Bucks debuted last night under the bright lights in L.A. Damian Lillard and Giannis making their preseason debuts for the Bucks, and it did not take long for Dame time to tick in this one.
Damian Lillard's got it on the left wing. Lillard going to fire away. Three-pointer, yeah, baby. Dame knocks it down right after Giannis does on the opposite wing. Lillard sticks his first field goal as a Buck here in this preseason.
Giannis led the team in scoring with 16, while Lillard added 14 as the Bucks go on for the 108-97 preseason win over the Lakers. And lastly, the Texas Rangers taking the 1-0 series lead in the ALCS with a 2-0 win over the Houston Astros on Sunday night. This sports update is brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown teams. Member FDIC.
The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. You know, Black-owned business give back is back, and we have teamed up with Associated Bank to help local black businesses grow and succeed together. The home of Milwaukee Black Talk will be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to five different black businesses each quarter of 2023. To sign up for this incredible marketing opportunity, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. It's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure on the truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank. Member FDIC. So there you go. There you go. Nah. You're going to throw that away. 833-212-1017 is the number. Oh, let me go check my talking text line. I have been remiss to check the talking text line. I've just left it sitting there looking all, what they call it, wise and otherwise. Talking text line, Brian said he lucky he got 2 years in probation. Well, he got 2.5 years in prison and 3 years of extended supervision. So he didn't get probation. He got extended supervision, so he'll be on parole. And then he added they were both black. Yes, that is correct. Craig says, shaking my head, she feel like all black people should be demonized because we're all criminals, we're all thieves, or hyper-aggression. Oh, stop. Shaking my head because that's what's written and said about us in the media. Does it make it true? No, it doesn't make it true. But I think sometimes people, and understand the context I'm using, liberal. Sometimes people are so liberal that they believe in order to stop something, they can actually abridge your civil rights and do whatever they want to do for the good of the children. And that's the lie that we've been told for decades, right? For the good of the children, for the good of the community, for the good of, and then if you say something about it, then you're, you know, you're castigated because you don't care about the children. Well, in some instances, no, I don't care about the children. They need to take their behinds to school, learn, graduate, all that stuff, right? But if you say anything about that, they can always find the one instance where your argument doesn't work and then say, see, well, that's not fair. Bottom line is the majority of kids are good kids and they go to school and they function and do their work and all that. But when someone does something to a child, you should pay for it. That's all I'm saying. What's the old saying? When you point your finger at somebody, there's always three fingers always pointing back at you. Yeah, that's me too. And we all make mistakes, and it's unfortunate. And not everybody has to pay for everything when they make a mistake. But then there's some instances where it's intentional, and you should pay. That's all I'm saying. Along with some compassion, along with some humanity, that goes a long way. But we need to recognize we can't just up and say, well, where there's smoke, there's fire. That's the biggest lie I've ever heard. That's about as big a lie as, well, when one person tells a story and another person still tells a story, I've learned that the truth is somewhere in the middle. What? Idiotic. That is the most idiotic statement I've ever heard. Truth stands on its own. Whether you agree with it or not, whether you like it or not, whether you oppose it or not, it stands on its own. It doesn't need anything to undergird it, doesn't need anything to pull it up. Truth is truth. So there is no, oh, that's your truth. That's my truth. No, that's not how truth works. Truth stands on its own. It don't need you. Well, that's my truth. Well, your truth is idiotic. And then what? Then when it fails you, is it your truth? Or is it something you want to now avoid? Like, it doesn't change. Truth doesn't change from person to person to person. It remains consistent. And we like to pretend like that doesn't happen. We like to pretend like, well, that's not really true. My truth is, well, I don't really care what your truth is. And you shouldn't care what my truth is. You would believe, and this is why we call it the truth. Not a truth. That's why when you're in court, you raise your hand and you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth. Not a truth, a whole truth, and nothing but a truth. Like, it, that's not how it works. Because then you can generalize and be kind of right and be kind of clear. I might have to go back and read what Craig was saying. John said that woman is clearly living in a land of fantasy. It's people like her with that same mindset. They're a detriment to the human race. Hang up on her. I'm tired of listening to her talk. She's making my ears bleed. The fact that she keeps saying, well, I mean, goes especially to show that she's just talking. No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. Different people have different speech patterns and different ways of talking, and that's just how she is. Don't bash her because she don't talk like you. Because she doesn't express herself like you. I was going at her pretty hard, and she kind of held her own. That's what I like about her. She kind of holds her own, and she's open to listening. Dr. Ken, do you remember the movie Al? You read my mind. The Minority Report with Tom Cruise, that's what it sounds like. Your last caller wants to go to a system. You can see how that movie played out. Yeah. They had a group of empaths that were able to tell what you were going to do before you did it. And the problem was they could feed dreams to the empaths to make, all right, we're going to feed this to the empath. Rhea is going to steal her own hat and then say that she stole it, and anybody that makes a false official report goes to jail for 50 years. Okay. And then they plant it in the doggone empath, and now all of a sudden they believe it. So it's, no, come on. You're so right. Minority Report. It's when the smallest group of people controls the largest group of people, then there's a problem. That's a problem. When the few control the many, that's an issue. 833-212-1017 is the number. Let me go back and check the talk and text line and make sure there's nothing left. Melissa went back to my comment on having to have two of everything and all that. She said, could be a form of OCD. For me, I can't do anything unless my home is clean and in order. The problem is I'm always cleaning and putting things in order. I feel you. I have to let things go. And then all of a sudden, I get in a cleaning frenzy and I have to clean everything. And so when I get in a cleaning frenzy, I just start throwing stuff away. I look at it and I go, I haven't looked through this and I think I'm going to need this, but I don't think I'm going to need this because I have it in my drive. So I'm throwing it away. So I just throw it all away. Literally. Now, what I won't throw away are my bags. So I go to a lot of conferences and I go to a lot of different organizational things and everywhere you go, which I don't really understand why they give you a bag when you don't really use it anyway. Give me a notebook I can write in and I'm done. But they give you a bag. And so I have a bag for everything. And you know what I'm going to do? Tomorrow, I'm going to bring in all of my badges that I use, that I've worn at different conferences over the years. I looked at it yesterday, and I just went, I think I should stop going. Because it's too many. It's too many. But I'm keeping my bags because I got a couple coach bags that, you know, it's gonna, I'm going to keep those. I think I'm going to keep them. I think I'm going to keep them. I think, yeah. That's just me.
One call, that's all.
One call. I love it. One call, that's all is right. It's your chance to win your one call, that's all. 5K giveaway. You'll be entered in to win. I think, are we drawing this month? Next month? I think we're drawing at the end of the month. I'm not. Somebody else is. I can't tell you who, but they'll tell you. So you got to keep listening. But you heard it right. $5,000. You have a chance to win. 833-212-1017 is the number. Be caller number 5 at 833-212-1017. 833 212-1017. Be caller number 5, and you will be entered in to win $5,000. Remember, if you or a loved one has ever been injured in an accident, call Gruber Law Offices now. One call, that's all. Be caller number 5 for your chance to win, to be entered in, to win this money from the One Call That's All 5K giveaway. For official contest rules, visit 1017thetruth.com. Caller number 5, 833-212-1017.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
It is big week for Network Health. Truth Nation, the annual Medicare enrollment period is here. Network Health offers great health plans for you to enroll in. Medicare is health insurance for people 65 and older and some younger people with disabilities. If you or a loved one meets these qualifications, you must tune in to our educational Big Week interview with Network Health this Wednesday on The Truth with Sherwin Hughes at 11 a.m. and Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris at 5 p.m. Learn more about the great health plans for Network Health during Big Week on 1017 The Truth.
Hardworking family businesses, ambitious entrepreneurs, relationship builders, job creators, businesses like yours are the heart of Wisconsin, and Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation lives to help you realize your vision. Join us for Marketplace Wisconsin, the Governor's Conference on Diverse Business Development, held December 6th and 7th at the Baird Convention Center, downtown Milwaukee, virtually on the 5th. Presented by WEDC. Marketplace Wisconsin is a chance for minority, women, LGBTQ+, veteran-owned, and small businesses to network, explore government contracting, and grow. You keep our state moving with construction, janitorial services, logistics, and transportation, technology, medical services, and much more. The Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation wants to help propel your success. Join us at Marketplace Wisconsin, the Governor's Conference on Diverse Business Development, December 6th and 7th. Register for Marketplace Wisconsin by going to MarketplaceWisconsin.com. Let's move forward together.
All right, Team Pella, listen up.
Thanks, John Kuhn. Customers love our products with limited lifetime warranties.
It's 1017 The Truth, Dr. Ken Harris for Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Check out these big plays. Incredible innovations like blinds and shades between the glass. Stylish windows with hidden screens that make game days a breeze. With monthly payments as low as $19 per window, $75 per patio door, and a free quote at PellaWI.com.
Let's go.
6.99 APR for 120 months. Certain restricted supplies and showroom. Offers on 10/31/2023.
Hi, John McGivern here. Did you know Network Health Medicare Advantage plans start at $0 a month? And you can get the extra benefits you need, like dental, vision, over-the-counter items, and more? I know because I'm a member myself. Call 833-7-NETWORK to learn more today. Network Health Medicare Advantage plans include PPO plans with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in Network Health Medicare Advantage plans depends on contract renewal.
Bucks basketball is back. A new era tips off with Coach Griffin at the helm, alongside returning favorites and exciting new additions. It's Dame time, Milwaukee. Don't miss a moment of the action. From the electrifying slam dunks to the roar of 18,000 fans, all unfolding live at Fiserv Forum. Secure your seats now. Visit bucks.com/tickets and join us for an unforgettable season of Bucks basketball. There's a seat waiting for you at Fiserv Forum. Secure yours now at bucks.com/tickets.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You can keep that going. I'm going to just party from now till, yep. Want to say congratulations to Don for being, for what am I even talking about? He's entered in to win the One Call That's All 5K giveaway. He is now eligible to be the winner. I also want to remind you the Truth is home of Marquette University High School Hilltopper football. High school football playoffs is here. Hilltoppers look to start their playoff journey. Now we got a playoff journey. Like this. Some of the words we use these days is just like, it's a journey. No, it's not. We're family. No, we're not. This is a road to a victory as they host the Sheboygan North Golden Raiders. Kickoff is at 7 this Friday. The pregame is at 6:30. So make sure you hang out. High school sports and on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is presented by Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all. So, anyway. So, yeah. I'm partial to the Marquette University High School Hilltoppers. I'm partial to the DSHA Dashers. That's all. Somebody got a problem with it? Come holler at a brother. I'm just saying. 833-212-1017 is the number. You know, it just dawned on me something I have to do in November, and it just dawned on me, like, you should probably check what you got to do that day. No. Is it that day? No. Uh-oh. You know how something crosses your mind, and instead of waiting, you just have to make sure you go in. Don't you love doing things on the air live? Uh-oh. So I just found out I have to be somewhere in November, and I'm trying to find out when it is, but somebody sent me an email, and now I have to check to see. Oh, wow. Yep. Got to cancel it. Can't be there. Oh, well. You know how you got to be somewhere and then you appreciate and then all of a sudden you realize you actually can't make it because you have something else you have to do. Oh, well. Guess I'll cancel. It's unfortunate. But what do you do, right? Oh, well. I'm depressed. I'm going to go cry now. Okay, I'm done crying. 833-212-1017 is the number. Let me double check my talk and text line. See if anybody's. CJ said, "You stay impartial. That's why I like your show." Well, one, thank you. Second, I stay impartial, but when I'm not impartial, when I'm biased, I kind of like to tell you I'm biased and here's why. I'm biased and here's why. When many times when people don't like one or the other, that's when they pretend to be biased and want to move to the middle. Right? That's when everybody says, well, we do that too, or the other side does that too, because they don't want their side to look bad. When in fact, if you try to reside there all the time and look at things in a balanced perspective, then it's okay to have a side. Like I'm right now, people are on this whole Hamas and Israeli issue of if you don't side with Israel, you're terrible. And if you don't understand what the Palestinians went through, you're terrible. As they bomb each other, kill each other, do all sorts of things. Who did it first? Who did it last? When in fact, somebody's going to have to go step in and stop both sides from fighting. But I don't think that's going to happen. Biden has already said that he's condemning thousands of years of prejudice against Jews. But people also understand that those in the Gaza Strip are human. And because you don't like them doesn't mean you get to kill them. right? It's got to be something. Something has to be done. Otherwise, they're going to destroy the region. And as usual, because they're not a part of NATO, which I was corrected on the other day, because they're not connected to the North Atlantic, then we're going to end up cleaning up the pieces, which I think is unfortunate. I think you should leave it to those democratic countries that are in that area, like Italy and Greece and France and Great Britain, right? They're there. Go handle that. Bye. But at some point, like, people still don't realize Egypt is in Africa. That Egypt is right there, abutted against it. Yep. That's unfortunate. And so how do you fix this? How do you have an opinion where you want to say how you feel, but you don't want people to take it the wrong way or be upset by it or anything? You know what I'm saying? I don't know. It kind of, I see both sides. I see both issues. I see both ways. And the weird part about it is I hear them both saying the same thing. And so how do you get through the noise and get both sides to stand down while somebody goes in and negotiates? They already got 30 Americans dead and about 12 missing, 17 missing. What are we doing? And we don't have a Speaker of the House. Where are we going? You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. Tory Lowe's show is coming up next. I will see you again on tomorrow, God willing, in about 22 hours. Rebroadcast at 4 a.m. And again, I'll be back 12 hours later at 4 p.m. to give you the latest news, weather, sports, traffic, Rhea, Dr. Ken, Kyle. We're just going to give you everything. I'm giving everything away tomorrow. All right. Thank you, Rhea. Appreciate you. God bless. Take care. I'm out.